Hello. Yeah. Today, now I want to talk about this kind of a progress review of what we have done. That is the project on people product president. Now, after we launched the concept with Facebook page, I got a lot of comments and feedback and some ideas. But then I got some interesting questions. Today, I expect to answer those questions very briefly, to enlighten some of you to join our project. Now, the first question is, now, even though we talk about neutral president, people ask, you know, President Maithripala is still the head or president of Sri Lanka Freedom Party as well as the UPFA. So how you handle that? Now, that is true. So now what we are saying is that president should be neutral. So we should enlighten him, we should enhance him to be neutral. Maybe he doesn't also understand the value of being neutral, because he always look at the political parties and politically active groups. So if we as the group of community representatives or the public, if we can convince president that being neutral, he can do better than being part of political parties, then there's a hope. So the idea is that we should encourage president to be neutral through our activities. The second question is, now there has no been kind of a political culture where there was a neutral president. President has been always a representative of a party, and he is working with through his party, you can say. Now that is also a valid question if you look at the Sri Lankan political history. But now my argument is that President Maithripala Sirisena came to become the president also in a non-conventional, non-traditional way. So he has never been the prime minister. He was not kind of groomed to be the president. By 2014 November till 2014 November, or rather October, we didn't know that he was going to be the president, or we didn't know he was going to be the candidate. So president was elected by the people through the forces of people. So we have seen some new changes in appointment of this president. So I think we don't have to rely only on the history, and we can rechange that, reshape that with new dynamics. Secondly, now there are new ways that we can communicate with the president, particularly the new technology. And president is also communicating with us through social media and his other forums, mechanisms. So we should be able to help him to get ideas from our side, and then he should be able to decide of being neutral. So we should not have any precedents of having a neutral president, so we can redefine it. Now, third question is about democratic culture of Sri Lanka, that is representative democracy that we have been practicing for more than 80 decades. So how a neutral president is compatible with that? That is also politically correct question. Now, my argument is that actually we don't have to just again rely on what has been happening. Now, if you look at Swiss model, where you see direct democracy, where people elect, people vote for every decision, even a minor decision, people of the particular area directly vote for that decision to say no and yes. So maybe we can learn from that that model of direct democracy, where to some extent, I'm not saying that we should give up parliamentary system and our institutional democratic arrangement, but at the same time there can be a parallel mechanism where people directly communicate with president and give their opinions. The second part is, now even in countries like United Kingdom, you have a queen who is not officially executive, but now she also has a lot of powers, for example, to dissolve parliament and even sack prime minister. But you can see not only in UK but also Kingdom of Thailand, king has some powers, but we don't see them practice frequently. So they keep the power and they allow prime minister to run the country, and only when there are national issues or when there are some kind of political chaos, only they will intervene. So in the same way, we also want, I am not talking about particular model, what I am saying is that we should have a president who is executive and he has executive powers, but then keep a back seat and have like lazy wear style of governance where prime minister and the parliament or the cabinet runs the country, they run the country, and then president involved only when there is a requirement, national disaster, national emergency, something like that. Now, as a part of that, now what we see is, or what we have been seeing is the president in everywhere, you know, for example, maybe it's a wedding, opening ATM machine, any minor issues, president is invited. That also should change. I think our president should, as the head of state, should, you know, involve in only important aspect, because Maithripala Sirisena has clearly mentioned that he will not campaign again. Therefore, to go to all these small minor events and ceremonies is not relevant. So that also should change. The next question is, now how long we should do this project, or how long we should try to work with the idea of protect the president. Now my suggestion is at least it should be for next 5 years, because the president is going to be the head of state for next 5 years. So at least for those 5 years, we can involve and engage with the president to make our voice heard. Now, another important question is, now people asking, what is in it for? For example, for me or for any person who is involving in the project. Now, that is an important question. I want to answer it very quickly and very clearly to clarify the position. Now, for example, now I am not a politician. I have also planned to involve in politics. So as a professional, what I want to do is contribute my expertise and, you know, my something I have gathered for the betterment of the country, and particularly for people who don't have a voice. And as a part of that, if you might have seen, people gather and they make organizing and they make political deals. Now that is not something we want to do. Now we want to remain as representative of the people, or, you know, voice for the people, not to make deals with president or any other political party and then get personal benefit. Now benefit we get is we will be leading, or we will be directing the country to a more democratic and more inclusive society. Other than that, if you want to, I'm going to have a deal with president or somebody else, then I should get out of this and somebody else should run. So the point is, protect the president by the people is a organization, or rather loose network of people's organization. It's not representative of president or anybody else. The final point is, now can this be successful? Now that is a difficult question to answer. Now what I would say is that we should try, we should make every possible effort to, you know, have this broader concept of people should direct the ruler. So with that concept, we should try to protect the president for the interest of the public, for the general public and the people. So success or failure will depend on how successfully we will engage, how intensely we will discuss and engage. So I invite again you to join the dynamics and involve in our work, and it's a success. Thank you.